dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.
Good evening and welcome to the Berks County Kennel Club's program, All About Dogs. Hi, I'm Pat Mock, your house, your host, your host. And I want to welcome you all to 2021 for what that's worth. So remember last month I told you I was going to have another different breed on? Well, we have it on. It is a Schappendoe. My guests this evening are Beth and Jeb Humma. It's nice to have a family involved in the same hobby. We usually either have the husband or the wife, but very seldom both. Suppose you tell us what a Schappendoe is.
The Schappendoes is originally bred as a sheep dog.
Oh, okay.
And for sheep driving.
Okay.
And it's from the Netherlands.
Really? Now, you wouldn't think of the Netherlands as having many sheep, would you? I mean, you think of tulips, but you don't think of sheep.
Well, the province that they're from is called Drenthe. It's the north,
okay,
in the north eastern part of the country next to the German border.
Okay.
And it's filled with heathland. And years ago, and prior to the invention of man-made fertilizer, they would graze the sheep on the heath in order to make it fertile.
Okay.
So the sheep manure
made
it fertile so they could grow crops. So that's where the breed really flourished at that time. And then after the invention of the fertilizer and some say the intervention of the border collie, then the Schappendoes kind of went into remission.
Wow. Isn't that interesting? Yeah, you wouldn't even think of that. And probably the fertilizer from the sheep is much better than the fertilizer that, you know, they're using now, but that's beside the point, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
So he's about how heavy? I mean, he looks big. What is he, about 18, 20 inches to the shoulder? How tall is he?
Yeah, he is. He's about a little over 17, between 17 and 18.
Okay,
he's about
35
pounds.
Really?
And the breed standard is 16 to 20 inches. And anywhere from the 26, I think, to 55 pounds, the bigger males.
So. Okay.
So he's right in the middle.
Yeah. So this breed is not recognized by the AKC yet, correct?
Correct.
Okay.
They have foundation stock.
Right.
But not recognized.
The FSS. Yeah, FSS. Okay. Foundations stock. Foundation.
I'm not sure. I don't know a lot about AKC.
Yeah. Foundations? Oh, well, it doesn't really matter. It's FSS. That's all I know about FSS. But so what do they have to do to get recognized? Is it the number of dogs? How popular is this breed?
The breed, let me look at that paper that I... we had asked about that, how many dogs there are in North America. And the reply that I got was that there is... what's called the dose data, and there's 390 Schappendoes that are registered in the dose data, but that includes all the years. So there might there's not even 390 anymore. It's just all the years
they
are registered.
Right, they don't take them
People
off when
don't
the dog
always
dies.
Say
right,
when their dog
right.
dies.
Yeah.
And that is probably all of North America because most of the United States dogs come out of Canada.
Oh, okay.
You know.
Oh, isn't that interesting?
Yeah, because we were told that there was, that they know of only one litter that was born in the United States. I don't know how accurate that is, but that's what we were told that they know of.
That's really a small gene pool, isn't it?
So there's several several good breeders in Canada.
Uh-huh.
And they still are importing a lot of dogs from Europe.
Okay. Is that where he's from, Canada?
Yeah, he comes from Canada.
So,
And his breeder's name is Messy Hair, which is the dose, is the Dutch word for messy hair. Tousled hair. And Schappen is the sheep.
Uh-huh.
So it's a tousled hair sheepdog, basically, or a Schappen dose.
And they're supposed to have messy, straggly hair. Not super combed, smooth, like you see some of these other beautiful,
the
bearded collies,
yes,
they look silky
and perfect. Every hair is in place,
right? These are supposed to show with messy hair. Yes. Okay. You know, like they're working.
Right, right.
And the only thing I trim them in is between his toes. Mm-hmm. I don't even trim around his feet.
What about underneath?
Yeah, just okay, under. Okay, just okay. That's what I meant. On the pads underneath.
Okay.
But I don't trim anything else. He's shown just like he is.
Natural.
Yeah, except he doesn't have this knot. In the
okay.
show.
Oh, don't they allow the top knot when you're showing?
Not
them?
In confirmation.
Oh,
no.
Okay, yeah. Okay. I didn't know
yeah,
that.
Yeah, he would just have a full head of hair, and then he kind of looks out between. The
okay.
Or if he's moving fast, the hair blows back.
Right. Yeah, that's interesting that so many of the herding breeds have the hair across the face.
Yeah.
You know, and I have a herding breed and it doesn't. Mm-hmm. So you wonder if it's the different parts of the country or, you know, when they were developed, why some would have hair on their faces and some not.
Yeah, they're probably related to a lot of those other long-haired sheepdogs.
Yeah, do you know what's in their background? What breeds are in their background?
They believe that they're related to...
the Old English.
The Old English, the...
sheepdog and the Polish lowlands sheepdog.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So they're similar.
And the bearded collie, yes, you know, some of those other similar ones. They think, you know, way back that they were related.
Yeah, well, they were mostly interested in how well the dog worked, not necessarily what it looked like, but how well it worked.
Right.
Yeah, there was a quote I was looking for that I can't find it now, but that's exactly what you're
about
saying.
One
of their earlier developers, he said he didn't want a stainless steel kitchen knife. Where, you know, knives years ago were hand-forged of quality steel.
The stainless steel
were stamped out, mass-produced, and they lacked the quality.
Yeah.
And he was afraid that would happen to this breed.
Okay.
He said the goal is to never lose the working ability.
Right.
You know.
Right.
Yeah. He didn't want a show dog, he wanted a working dog.
Right. And it's nice that AKC now does that as well. You know, they've been doing that for quite a while. That the dog is supposed to do what it was bred for.
Oh, okay.
And that's obviously what the Schappendoe would be doing as well. Mm-hmm. Schappendoe. Mm-hmm. Whatever. I'm not Dutch, so. Sorry, I'll have to remember it's Schappendoe. So are there any more in the close vicinity here?
There's one in the Philadelphia area on the main line.
Yeah, I think there's two down there, but one of them comes up to the sheep herding event.
Okay.
But we've never met yet.
Yeah, we haven't met her yet.
Huh. Interesting. Very interesting. Now, is this the only color they come in?
Well, if you'd like to see the other colors, we could show you a little slideshow.
Well, so they come in various colors.
Yeah, they're any color is allowed. Any color is acceptable.
Okay. Well, we'll see that a little bit later on.
Okay, that's fine.
I want to get to the specifics.
Okay.
Since it is hairy, grooming.
Okay.
How much grooming do you have to do in this dog?
Okay.
What does the coat feel like?
I shouldn't step away from the microphone. It's soft, but it's not like a real silky soft.
Okay.
It's supposed to be a little bit harder because they're a working...
Okay.
You know, working coat.
And they are double coated.
If you want to...
Stand.
Yeah, go over to Pat and she can... You know better the terminology than what I do.
Hey, Quincy.
Quincy. Go ahead.
Hi, Guy. Yeah, he's very soft. Of course, now you're not going to get him back.
Yeah.
he has his nose underneath the desk here. He's pushing it out of the way.
Come on. Oh, boy.
But it's a very soft, fluffy, basically a fluffy coat. It doesn't have any harshness at all.
Right, but he's not even 2 years yet.
Right.
You know, so.
But looking at him, you would think that the coat would be a harder coat.
Okay.
But it's not at all. It's a cuddly coat.
Oh, right.
that's what it's like, a cuddly coat.
Yeah, so, and as far as grooming, when he went through different puppy stages, I had to groom a lot.
Okay.
You know, but then in autumn and different things. But now that he has his adult coat, and now that winter's here, in the summer, he was in the creek every day getting muddy. And But now that winter's here, I have very little grooming.
Okay.
You know, it's surprisingly little grooming for the amount of hair that there is.
Well, he does have the double coat, though.
Yes. So when I groom him, I'll generally do the what they call line grooming,
know,
where you fold it backwards
back
and make
combing.
Sure
right.
to get the undercoat.
Undercoat, right.
Because they can get fine little mats in the undercoat if you don't properly brush the undercoat.
Right, right.
But I don't have to do that frequently, you know. Mainly, like tonight, I did a thorough brushing, you know, and that was sufficient.
Yeah, so like once a week maybe? That you would have to brush him?
Once a week I try to do a nice job, and then I just nip the toenails a little bit just to keep those trim.
Yeah, unfortunately those keep growing, don't they?
Yeah.
Everybody hates to do toenails. Everybody hates nails.
He sleeps through it.
Oh, does he really?
Yeah.
Oh, my word. No, mine sit there. I'm not going to look, that kind of thing. So exercise, do they need a lot of exercise since they are herding dogs? Do they require a lot of exercise?
They don't require a lot of exercise. He sleeps under my desk all day long when I'm working. He just sleeps. He doesn't get destructive or anything. But then in the evening, we try to spend a little time with him. You know, like today, I took him for a long walk, maybe 2 miles.
Okay.
Other times, he'll come home and throw the frisbee, you know, or we'll have the neighbors over with their dogs about once a week, and they just play, you know, off lead and do whatever they want.
Okay.
So as long as he gets a little something every day, he's fine.
So he would be okay then? This breed would be okay like in an apartment or with an elderly couple?
As long as they get activity, mental stimulation, and some kind of activity every day.
Right, right, right.
But it doesn't have to be 5 hours a day, you know, or something.
Okay. So then he would be okay with an elderly couple, like in a retirement community?
Because
most of them get in a retirement community, they are constantly walking.
Right.
So.
Yeah. If they get activity and mental stimulation, you know, they should be fine.
Yeah.
And they're great with children.
Are they good with children? That's what I was going to ask next.
Yeah.
How they are with kids? Well, they would be more active with kids, obviously.
They love other kids. They love other dogs. They love people. They just love life.
Oh wow, that's great. That's great. As far as training, are they easy to train or?
I found him very easy to train. Mm-hmm, they're intelligent and they want to please.
Okay. Okay.
You know.
And he's sensitive to correction.
Yeah, he's sensitive to correction. So you know, we don't need a strong hand with him.
Right,
You know.
Well, I don't believe in that anyway. But
yeah.
That's
but,
just
we don't even need a strong voice.
Right,
You know, if he knows that he upset us, he's like, you know.
Yeah. Very good. Very good. So how about we see the video that you brought along or the slideshow that you brought along? We're going to see the different colors. You're going to be amazed at the colors these dogs come in.
The colors as well as the activities.
Okay. So then these are the colors. Well, obviously that red part was a bandana around the dog's neck.
Right.
So they can actually have all white bodies and just the colored heads?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, they could even have all white. There's no color restrictions at all.
Yeah.
Any color combination.
Well, you can see a lot of color combination. That almost looks like an English sheepdog there.
Yes.
It looks almost exactly like an English sheepdog. Mm-hmm.
Just a smaller version.
Yeah.
And these photos were contributed from people, Schappendoe's owners all around. A lot of them came out of Europe.
Oh, okay.
You know, as well as Canada.
Yeah, that red color is gorgeous. But it can be any blend of colors as well.
Yes.
And you can see how the coat flies back when they're running, how it flies away from their eyes.
Right.
Now, is that how they herd sheep? They actually do run after them? They're
the drovers.
Okay.
Yeah, they just to
round the sheep up like the Border Collie does.
Yeah, just to help the shepherds move.
Right. Yeah, because the German Shepherd keeps them in a specific area, whereas, you know.
And they're not guard dogs by any means.
Right.
So they don't have that quality.
That's his grandmother there in the middle. She's in Europe.
Yeah, there's quite a range. In fact, they're even multicolored.
Yes, and then here you'll see this first video, we picked this one because it's showing how
independent they are.
She's doing a wonderful job, but she's going to enjoy it. She took a moment out to say, hey, I'm going to have a good role here first, and then I'm going to, you know, and then she did wonderful, but she's going to enjoy it, and that's how they are. In the book that my husband's holding, it mentions how they do a wonderful job, but they, because they enjoy life so much, they can get distracted by a butterfly.
Yes.
You know?
I know about that. Yeah, I know about that. Oh, yeah, I see with the child.
There's a duck diving dog.
Oh, okay.
There, Quincy's on
my
lap.
There, yeah. And with the sheep.
Yeah, and even a lot of the black and white ones on here are other people's dogs. They look like my Quincy, but they're other dogs.
Right, right. And wow.
Some of them love to swim. I believe if you teach them early on, you know.
Oh, that one looks like it's cut down. That was the one that I said it looked like it was cut down. That the coat was not long.
Yeah, I don't know. Or it could have just been a shorter coat. I'm really not sure because I don't know the dog.
Right.
It was just
a
contributed photo.
And I would think that would probably be perfectly all right. If you cut it down, I mean, you cut it shorter.
Not for competition, though.
Well, no, not for competition, but so many breeds that have long coats are, you know, cut down. That guy must be really brave. He's in the snow and he doesn't have long sleeves on.
And that previous one was a rescue dog.
Oh, you mean they have them in rescue already?
I mean rescue work.
Oh, search and rescue dog. Okay,
rescue.
Okay. Yeah, they're wow, he has quite a flock there of sheep. Is that in a boat?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, they can do almost anything, can't they?
Yeah.
Whatever people do, that's what they
almost do. Any activity. That one is, I'm told, an international frisbee champion.
Wow. Yeah, they do like jumping.
Yeah, they love to jump.
No, nothing else, they do like jumping.
They love to jump. And Their gait is supposed to be...
Oh, this is... Yeah.
This is Quincy's sister, here. By the way.
Oh,
yeah, his littermate sister. So she looks like him. She's up in Canada. And this is typical. They just love life. They hop like that.
I think it's because they're short. They're trying to get a view of things.
Well, right. They're jumping up to see what else is out there.
Right.
But it's also fun.
Yeah. And when their typical gait has a very springy step.
Mm-hmm. And of course, when you bounce in the snow, you get little snowballs that fly as you bounce.
Yeah.
So.
And then we just, for enjoyment, we added a few puppy pictures. That's Quincy and his mom, the last picture of them together.
Yeah.
And then a lot of other dog pictures that were contributed. I had over 300 photos contributed. Unfortunately,
oh, wow.
I couldn't use all of them.
Yeah.
So I just tried to pick those that were different.
Yeah, you can tell the puppy coats, they're all scraggly. Isn't that interesting? A mother which is red and white and a black and white pup.
Mm-hmm.
That is an interesting color. Interesting coat on that dog. See, that one looks almost like it was cut down as well.
Well, it was a young puppy.
Yeah,
it
young dog.
It takes a while till their coats come in.
Right. But it's one thing my dogs can't do. They can't sit up. All righty. And that's that. The end. And we even got a little rough in there as well. Oh, my. So what health problems do these guys have?
They're relatively healthy, but some of the health checks that they do for before they breed is the hips are required, and also there's a retina
issue. Okay, the PRA.
that they require a health check on that.
Okay.
His breeder does other health checks as well, like the elbows and other things.
Right.
She's a very good breeder. The kennel name is Messy Hair,
uh-huh.
which is I think is just the best name because they're supposed
they are,
to have
right.
messy
they
hair.
They do have messy hair.
And that's what the dose means on Schappendoe.
Uh-huh.
It means messy hair. So.
Yeah, they are funny. Why did you select this breed?
We had Leonbergers before.
Mm-hmm.
And
a lot of dog?
Yeah, and we went for 10 years without because of some serious family, you know, health issues and so on. But then we were ready to get a dog again. We needed one that would make us get out and have exercise, get outside.
Right.
And I wanted something smaller this time so that I could take him anywhere I go.
Uh-huh.
I like because I can still lift him up and I'm not worried about hurting my back or anything. And we wanted something that was still fun-loving and loved everybody, just like the Leonbergers. They love everybody. They love life. They love people. They love dogs.
Right.
We made a long list of everything that we want in a breed, and we just looked at all kinds of different breeds until we found something that perfectly fit what we wanted. What other reasons can you think of?
We just needed joy in our life again, and he brings it.
Yes.
Yeah, he's always happy.
He always loves everything.
Always wagging.
He's never...
And when you look at them, you have to smile. They're so cute, you have to laugh at them.
And that's typical of the breed. They're always happy, always
and
wagging.
When we were invited from Messy here to see what they're all about. So we drove up, and the first thing his mom did before...
She was pregnant with him.
Yeah. She just came over, she sat at my feet, and just looked longingly into my eyes, you know, and that was it. That's how they are.
So now, you do show him. He's a champion.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah,
okay.
UKC. Yes.
Right. UKC is what? United Kennel Club.
Yes.
Right. And that's different from AKC how?
I don't know the details of AKC, one thing I really like with UKC is that you have to be the owner or the breeder to show the dog. There's no hired show handlers.
No professionals.
Right. So that's one thing I really like. So it's a lot more relaxed and enjoyable.
Yes. But I'm assuming that there are shows in this area, or do you have to travel far?
The closest that I know is Mechanicsburg.
Okay.
Which was, what, an hour or
from
our house.
Mechanicsburg's not that far away.
Yeah, and then there's, like, Virginia and Maryland. You know, there's a New Jersey, you know.
Yeah.
So there's some around.
Right. So you have to pre-enter the show, and you've seen Westminster, right?
Yes.
You know, on television, everybody sees Westminster. But how, you know, you take the dog in the ring and set it up, and are they shown on the table?
No, it's considered a ramp dog, but UKC doesn't have a ramp.
Okay.
So we kind of let it up to the judge, and some say table, others say the floor, you know.
Yeah, I just didn't know if they were shown on the table or not.
Yeah, it's borderline.
They're big for a table dog, but yeah. So you pre-enter the show like you would an AKC show, and they send you an armband and
we get the armband when we get to the location.
Oh, when you get to the show. Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
We register him online. There's an application, and then register for the show. There's a show calendar.
Okay.
On the UKC website.
Uh huh.
You know, so you pre-enter for the show, and then when you arrive at the show and you say, we're here, then they give you the armband.
Oh, okay.
You know.
Are a lot of dogs shown at UKC shows? I've never been to a UKC show because I've never been able to find one, you know. Oh, yeah, there was one last week. Well, that doesn't help me, you know.
I would guess that in his group, the herding group, there were at least 20 breeds.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, in the group ring.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of breeds that are shown.
Well, now they're only shown against other Schappendoes, right? So he would be like the only one.
All the
herding breeds go in together?
Yes.
Well, no, each individual, just like the AKC, each individual breed is shown, and they have the different levels and categories.
Okay.
Then the best of breed goes into group.
Okay.
You know, and then the best of group goes in for the best of show.
Okay. So then, yeah, it is. So he would be. So do you get points? If you're the only one there, do you get points?
You do get points. Because the judge has the option to say he doesn't even qualify for best of breed, you know.
Oh,
so
okay.
You do get points.
Okay.
And then they need, on a group level, they have to be able to place either 1-4 with at least one dog under them in order to get a leg towards a championship.
Oh, okay.
And
so
they
then
need
they
three
give you legs.
Legs to a championship.
Oh, three legs. Okay, okay.
Yeah. So he hasn't been shown against any other Schappendoes, but he was able to get all the legs and the points.
Yeah, that's what I didn't understand, how they, you know, if you were the only one, because with AKC, if you have no competition, you get no points.
Oh.
So, you know.
Not even at the group level.
Well,
because
you'd
he
have
would
to,
have to go to
if,
the...
If there was nobody else there, you could go for best of breed, but at that point, no, you're not going to get any points.
Okay.
You're not going to get any points.
Yeah.
So there has to be class competition.
Okay.
Or you have to take best of breed over, or you know, over other dogs to get any points.
Yeah.
So, yeah. So it's sometimes a little frustrating.
Yeah, I guess it's UKC is more catered to a lot of these smaller breeds.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
So, people like us.
And people like us that just ordinary
Dutch people. Right. Right. Yeah. Well, very good. I thank you so much for bringing him on. And he is a cutie. Aren't you, Quincy? You are a cutie. So next month, I'm not quite sure what we're going to be doing. We may have a vet. I'm hoping we have a vet, but we'll see. Who knows? Who knows? So for this evening, good night.
All About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.